Where do we find the slowest clocks in the universe? The answer lies in the most extreme places. Black holes. What if I told you there's a clock in the universe that takes longer than the entire history of the Earth just to tick once? Time doesn't tick at the same rate everywhere. In fact, it can actually slow down depending on where you are in the universe. But why does that happen? Imagine you're standing still and everything around you is moving. For you, time feels normal. Seconds tick by just as you expect. But if you were moving incredibly fast or near something with immense gravity, like a black hole, time would start to behave differently. Let's say you're on a treadmill, walking at a comfortable pace, while someone else is sprinting at full speed next to you. To them, time feels like it's rushing by, while for you, it's moving at a regular speed. But if you could watch them from your spot, their movements would seem almost in slow motion. That's time dilation in action. Time itself isn't the same for everyone, everywhere. So, where do we find the slowest clocks in the universe? The answer lies in the most extreme places. Black holes. A black hole is a region in space where gravity is so intense that nothing can escape. But what makes black holes truly fascinating is how they warp time itself. The closer you get to a black hole, the slower time ticks. And I'm not just talking about a little slowdown. I mean time can almost come to a complete standstill. To give you an idea, let's look at the example from the movie Interstellar. There's a planet near a massive black hole where time moves so slowly that 1 hour on the planet equals 7 years on Earth. That's the kind of time dilation we're talking about here. It's like having the slowest clock in the universe right in front of you. Imagine being an astronaut near one of these black holes. You spend just a few hours there, and when you return to Earth, everyone you know has aged decades. That's how powerful the effect of a black hole on time can be. So, how does this time dilation work near black holes? The closer you get to a black hole, the stronger its gravitational pull becomes. And as gravity increases, time slows down even more. It's as if the black hole is pulling on the very fabric of time, stretching it out like taffy. If you were watching someone fall toward a black hole, you'd see their movement slow down as they got closer to the event horizon, the point of no return. To you, it would look like they were moving in slow motion, almost frozen in time. But to them, everything would feel normal. They wouldn't even notice the difference. This extreme time dilation means that near a black hole, the concept of time as we know it starts to break down. Hours turn into years, and what feels like minutes to you could be decades back on Earth. That's why black holes are home to the slowest clocks in the universe. So, what's really causing time to slow down near a black hole? It all comes down to something called space-time. Picture space-time as a giant, stretchy fabric that covers the entire universe. Massive objects like stars or planets sit on this fabric and create dents in it, kind of like how a heavy ball would stretch a rubber sheet, but in four dimensions. Now, a black hole isn't just a heavy ball. It's like a supermassive bowling ball that creates a huge, deep dent in the fabric of space-time. This dent is so extreme that it stretches time itself. The deeper the dent, the slower time moves for anything caught in it. That's why time slows down so dramatically near a black hole. To visualize this, imagine you're rolling a marble across that stretched rubber sheet. As the marble gets closer to the heavy ball, it slows down and spirals inward, moving more and more slowly as it gets closer to the center. That's exactly what happens to time near a black hole. It gets pulled and stretched, slowing down to a crawl. Black holes aren't the only places in the universe where time slows down, though they're definitely the most extreme. Another place where you can find serious time dilation is near neutron stars. Neutron stars are the remnants of massive stars that have exploded into supernovae. They're incredibly dense. Just a teaspoon of neutron star material would weigh about as much as a mountain. This extreme density creates a strong gravitational field, similar to a black hole, but not quite as intense. If you could somehow stand on the surface of a neutron star, assuming you could survive the crushing gravity, you'd experience time moving slower than it does on Earth, though not as dramatically as near a black hole. To give you an idea, if you spent an hour on a neutron star, a little more time would have passed on Earth, but not by the same extreme factor as with a black hole. So, while black holes hold the record for the slowest clocks in the universe, neutron stars aren't too far behind. They're like the runners-up in this cosmic race against time. Okay, so black holes and neutron stars are out there in the distant cosmos, but did you know that time dilation is happening here on Earth, too? It's not as dramatic, but it's real, and it actually affects your everyday life. Let's talk about GPS satellites. These satellites orbit the Earth at a high altitude and at incredible speeds. Because of this, they experience both less gravity than we do on Earth, and they're moving really fast. Two key factors that cause time dilation. The result? Time on these satellites actually runs slightly faster than it does down here on Earth. But here's where it gets interesting. If we didn't account for this tiny difference in time, your GPS would be off by several kilometers every day. Without correcting for time dilation, your navigation system would lead you way off course. So, even though we're not near a black hole or a neutron star, time dilation still plays a crucial role in our technology. It's a small effect, but it's a reminder that time isn't as rigid as we might think. It's flexible, and it changes depending on where you are and how fast you're moving, even here on Earth. Now, let's take this concept of time dilation to its absolute extreme. We've talked about how time slows down near a black hole, but what happens when you get so close to a black hole that you cross the event horizon, the point of no return? At the event horizon, gravity is so intense that not even light can escape. And this is where things get really mind-bending. As you approach the event horizon, time slows down more and more. But once you cross it, time, from the perspective of an outside observer, comes to a complete stop. For anything falling into a black hole, the closer it gets to the event horizon, the slower time moves. Right at the edge, time would seem to freeze. From your perspective, though, time would continue normally. You wouldn't notice anything strange. But to the outside universe, it would look like you're frozen in time, suspended in the event horizon forever. This isn't just a theoretical idea. It's a consequence of Einstein's theory of general relativity. Inside a black hole, the normal rules of time and space break down completely. Time and space switch roles, and time as we understand it effectively ceases to exist. It's as if the black hole is the ultimate time machine, but instead of taking you through time, it traps you in a moment that lasts forever. So, time isn't constant. It's flexible, it bends, and it can be stretched depending on where you are and what's around you. As we continue to explore space, understanding how time works under different conditions will be crucial, especially when we start talking about long-term space travel, or even the potential for time travel, at least in a theoretical sense. Don't forget to watch the video on the right and subscribe. Thanks for being part of Cosmoknowledge.